Hi everyone, Zoltan here and welcome to another video. So let me give you a quick look on our actual retro PC. So we have the this is the ASRock 4-core dual VSTA motherboard we've been using for many videos already, and we use the AGP slot and also the PCI Express. We have tried DDR and DDR2 memories. We have tried different CPUs like the Pentium 4, the Pentium D, the Core 2 Duo and the Core 2 Quad also. And this time I have two DDR2 memories running at 666, I guess. This one is an 800 MHz one, but the motherboard only supports 666, and I also want to use dual channel memory. And I have the Q6600 here running at 2.5 GHz, which was the maximum in this motherboard. And I have this Fatality cooler here, also a simple hard drive with the SATA connection and a Nexus power supply for 30 watts, and a CD drive. I think it's a DVD writer, but never mind. And this time I have a new motherboard, the Asus P5Q Pro, which is a really, really good one for the 775 socket, and I think I will be able to OC the Q6600 this around 3.2 GHz. So this is the plan, using two DDR2 memories at 666, because this is the best I have. And also now I have to switch to PCI Express. I will only use one slot. I could use Crossfire if I had two graphics cards from ATI or AMD, whatever. So yeah, it's a nice motherboard. It would support FSB up to 1600, and the memory is up to 1200 MHz, so it's a good one. Also, about graphics card, I've been using this H3 3850, very nice one. There is the PCI Express to AGP converter chip here, and I have tried the HD 2600 AGP version with 512 megabytes of RAM in this PC, and I also tried this PCI Express version of the same card, which is not requiring an additional power connector here, and it's only 256 megabytes, and I've tested this as well with the GPU-Z. Same clocks on the core and the memory, everything is exactly the same, but this motherboard only supports 4x PCI Express, and it just gave me horrible frame rates in Skyrim. With the HD 3850, I had around 24 FPS in my test scenario, and 20 with the HD 2600 XT, which is really good. And yeah, but with the PCI Express version, I only had around 10 frames per second, which was unplayable. And I think it's a great bottleneck of the PCI Express slot in this motherboard. And also, I had graphical glitches, vertices around the place, so it wasn't good. So now I will switch this motherboard with the Asus one, and I will test the performance. I really hope Windows XP will be stable and I don't have to reinstall it soon, and test if this card will be as fast as the AGP version. At least I hope the memory won't be an issue for it. And I also want to try the taping on the Q6600, just put one or two pieces of tape in the right pins and see if it will OC the FSB from 1066 to 3033, and it should give at 3.0 GHz by default without increasing the overall FSB of the motherboard or affecting the memories or anything. And it is a really simple trick and it should work. Yeah, Okay, thank you so much for watching and see you in the next video. Bye bye.